Okay, welcome everyone, myself Priyanka Kulkarni, and we are going to discuss or we are going to see the one topic from the biochemistry that is nothing but the lipid. It is the biomolecule. We'll see the structure and the functions of the molecule lipid. So basically, what is mean by the lipids? Lipids, which is describe a chemically varied group of the fatty substance and are highly concentrated energy source. They are water insoluble biomolecules, but it is soluble in the organic solvent such as the ether, benzene, chloroform, etc. Means this lipid molecule, it is also known as the sum of the fatty acids, which are highly insoluble in the water but which highly soluble in the different types of the organic solvents. What is mean by the lipid? It is the esters of long chains of the fatty acids and the alcohol. This is the basic definition of the lipid. Then what are the functions of this lipid? It serves as a fuel molecule for your body. It also acts as a cell signaling molecule. Then, it acts as a structural component of the membrane system. Also acts as a hormones and the intracellular messengers. If there is a low level of the free fatty acid, it is occurs in all the tissues. But it is found more concentration in the plasma during the fasting stage. The esters means what is lipid? They are the esters of long chain of fatty acids and alcohol. So that esters are derived from the carboxylic acid, means COOH group. And in an ester, whatever the hydrocarbon in this group, it is replaced by the hydrocarbon group of the some kind. This could be an alkyl group such as the methyl or ethyl, or one containing a benzene ring like a phenyl. Okay, next we'll see some functions of the lipid. What are the functions of the lipid? There are the many functions of the lipid, such as it is a basic component or the constituent of the cell membrane, which is very useful to regulate the permeability of that membrane. Next, it helps to protect the internal organ by acting as an insulating material, and it gives the shape and smoothness to your body. Then, it is a source for the fat soluble vitamins, means there are the some vitamins which are soluble only in the fat. So it acts as a source for the fat soluble vitamin. Then there are some essential fatty acids which are useful for the transport of the cholesterol and the formation of the lipoprotein. This is very necessary. Then there are some phospholipid which is present in the mitochondria, responsible for the transport of ETC, electron transport chain components. Then next, accumulation of fat in a liver is prevented by the phospholipid. Then this phospholipid, it helps in the removal of the cholesterol from your body by participating in the reverse cholesterol transport. Then the cholesterol is a constituent of membrane structure and it synthesizes the bile acids, hormones and vitamin D. Means this cholesterol is also important in your body. It has the some functions like for the synthesis of the bile acid, vitamin D and some hormones, and also it is present in the membrane of the cell. It is the principal sterol of the higher animal and abundant in the nerve tissue and the gallstones. There are some more functions, as I told you previously, that it is a main functions in the structural component of the cell membrane. Then it also acts as a cofactor for the different enzymes like the vitamin K act as a cofactor, then the coenzyme Q, vitamin K for the blood clot formation, coenzyme Q for the ATP synthesis in the mitochondria. It also acts as a signaling molecule. There are the many signaling ways like the paracrine signaling. So it acts as a paracrine hormone. Paracrine means which act on the local area or nearby area. Steroid hormone, it act body wide. Then it also functions as a growth factor, vitamin A and D, which act as a hormone precursor. The hormone precursor for this is nothing but a fat molecule. Then it also act as a pigment, like the colors of the tomato, carrot, pumpkins and some birds. And it also functions as an antioxidant. We'll see the classification of lipid. Based on their biological function, lipids are classified into the main two or three classes. That is the storage lipid and structural lipid. In its name only, storage lipid. Storage means what? It stores the some form of energy in your body. And structural lipid means the major structural element of the biological membrane. Lipids are the also act as a signal cofactors and the pigment, as I told you early. Next, the classification of lipid are basically in a 3 to 4 classes, like a simple lipid, complex lipid, derived lipid and the miscellaneous lipids, which is based on the chemical composition. Previously we see the classification based on the biological nature or the biological function of that lipid molecule, but these are the classification regarding to the chemical composition. First class is the simple lipid. Simple lipid means what? These are the just simple lipids of esters. These are the esters of fatty acids with the alcohol. They are of the three types, okay? Waxes, sterol ester and the triacylglycerol, which is also known as TAG. Then compound or complex lipid means these lipids are the esters of fatty acid with the alcohol with additional group such as the phosphate, nitrogenous bases, etc. They are again divided into the three types: phospholipid, glycerophospholipid and sphingophospholipid. Then third one is the derived lipids. Derived lipid means what? These lipids are obtained on the hydrolysis of the simple and the complex lipids. These lipids contain the glycerol molecules and other alcohols. This class of lipid, it includes the steroid hormone, ketone bodies, hydrocarbon, fatty acid, fatty alcohol, mono and diacyl glycerides. Then fourth is the miscellaneous lipids. This includes the compound which contain the characteristics of the lipid. They include the terpenes, hydrocarbons, carotenoids, etc. So these are some graphical representation of classification of the lipid on the basis of their chemical structure or chemical composition. So here we can see there is a simple lipid, complex lipid and the derived lipid. Simple lipid are of the three forms: wax, sterol and the triacylglycerol. Complex further divided into the main two types: phospholipid and glycolipid. Glycolipids, there are two types: cerebrosides and gangliosides. Phospholipid, there are again two types: glycerophospholipid, means where the glycerol is the basic unit, and the sphingophospholipid. In the glycerophospholipid, there are some names like the phosphatidylcholine, PC, phosphatidylethanolamine, PE, and phosphatidylinositol, PI. And in the sphingolipid, ceramide and sphingomyelin. Now the derived means what? From the hydrolysis of the simple and the complex lipids. These are the fatty acids, sterol, diglycerides and monoglycerides. Yes, storage lipids. Storage lipids, it includes the fat and oil and waxes. Now, what is mean by the fats and oils? These are composed of the three fatty acids, each in a ester linkage with a single glycerol molecule, means TAG, triacyl glycerol. Means here the basic is the glycerol molecule to which the three different types of the fatty acid chains are attached. Then waxes. Waxes are the esters of the long chains from the C14 to C36, means carbon 14 to carbon 36, saturated and unsaturated fatty acid with the long chain alcohols. We'll see TAG, triacyl glycerol, also called as the triglyceride. It is an ester of glycerol with the three fatty acid, also known as the neutral fat. They are stored in the adipocyte or adipose tissues in the animals and the endosperms and the cotyledon cells in the plants. A mammal contains 5% to 25% or more of its body weight as a lipid and 90% TAG. So, most of the lipids which are present in the, our body, it is in the form of TAG, and very less it is in the form of waxes. Yes, here are the some fats stored in the animal and the plant cells. Yes, in the animal cell, the fat cells means adipocytes. It is stored in the adipose tissue. Then in the plant cell, as I told you, it is stored in the cotyledonous cells or in the endosperm. Yes, this is a structure of triacyl glycerol. We can see here, basic structure is a glycerol molecule to which R1, R2 and R3. This R1, R2 and R3 are the functional group of this glycerol which is attached to it. And this R1, R2, R3, it may be the same group of fatty acid or it may be the different group of fatty acid. If at the both or at the three positions, the same fatty acid is attached, we can call it as a simple TAG. Means if R1, R2 and R3 are the same fatty acid, then we can call it as a simple TAG. And if it has a different, as it is shown in the figure, which is on the right side, it is the mixed TAG. Fats and oil. Yes, TAG means what? Fats and oil. Most occurring TAG are the mixed TAG, which contain two or more different fatty acids. It is a nonpolar hydrophobic molecule, essentially insoluble in water. We'll see little bit about the fatty acids. These are composed of the carbon hydrogen on the oxygen molecule, which is in the proportion of, like, the carbon is the 76%. Hydrogen is 12.6% and the oxygen is 11.3%. It is a carboxylic acid with the hydrocarbon chain ranging from the 4 to 36. Yes, what is mean by fatty acid? It is a carboxylic acid with a hydrocarbon chain. Yes, fatty acids are of the two types, saturated fatty acids and the unsaturated fatty acids. Saturated fatty acids means it don't have a double bond, and thus the hydrocarbon chain is completely unbranched, while unsaturated means it carries one or more double bond. It is either in the cis conformation or the trans conformation, but mostly the double bond is present in the cis conformation. In a polyunsaturated fatty acid, there are 2 to 6 double bonds are present. Yes, this is the nomenclature of fatty acid. Here we can see COOH group, means it is a carboxylic acid attached to the hydrocarbon chain, and behind it is a hydrocarbon chain. Here the numbering to the carbon atom is given, and we can see here there is a 18 carbon chain. So here 18 S2 3. So what is S2 3? It is nothing but the number of double bonds. Here we can see in between the carbon number 9 and 10, 12 and 13, 15 and 16, there is a double bond is present. So there is a sign delta which helps to represent the double bond carbon number. So double bond where it is present at the carbon 9, 12 and the 15. And 18s2 3, 18 means it is a number of carbon and 3 means number of double bond. 3 are the 3 double bonds are present over here. It is the most commonly occurring fatty acids, has the even number of carbon atom in an unbranched chain of 12 to 24 carbons. Yes, there are some systematic names are given to this fatty acid chain based on the IUPAC nomenclature. Here we can see as a numbering, there are the 12 number of carbon chain. First is the COOH and remaining is the hydrocarbon chain. So it is a 12 carbon chain. It is called as the dodecanoic acid or the lauric acid. We can see 14S2O, as 14S2O, 16S2O means 14 carbon, but there is a no double bond. 16 carbon, no double bond. 20 carbon, no double bond. So it is a tetradecanoic acid, hexadecanoic acid, icosanoic acid. Okay, like this. If there is a no double bond, for example 18S2O, okay, then it is a octadecanoic acid. Here in the spelling we can see there is a decanoic A. Okay, and if there is a double bond, then that A is replaced by the E. Okay, decanoic acid and decanoic acid. Yes. What are the patterns of the double bonds present in this? The most common position of the double bonds are 9, 12 and 15. The double bonds of polyunsaturated fatty acids, which are separated by methyl group like the CH2 group, and mostly, as I told you, the fatty acid, the double bond present in the fatty acid are in the cis configuration. Yes, here we can see the packaging of the fatty acid in the above figure, or the figure number 1. We can see there is a carboxyl group, and below the carboxyl group there is a hydrocarbon chain. As we can see, there is a, in the first figure, there is a no double bond is present, so we can call it as a saturated fatty acid. And in the second figure we can see there is a double bond is present, and because of that double bond the kink is produced in the structure, so it is a unsaturated fatty acid. So whatever the saturated fatty acid, it is a more stable arrangement of the fatty acids, and where the kink is present or the in an unsaturated fatty acid, it is a less stable arrangement of the fatty acid. We'll see some physical properties of the fatty acid, like the physical property of fatty acids are determined by the length and the degree of unsaturation of the hydrocarbon chain. Means the longer the chain, the fewer the double bonds, and the lower is the solubility in the water. Means if the chain is longer, and if the chain is longer and it don't have the double bond, means it is not soluble in the water and has a higher melting point. Next important point is, if we add the double bond or is there any double bond is present, then it decreases the melting point, whereas increasing the chain length increases the melting point. Okay, two points are very important. If the length is increases, it increases the melting point, and if double bond is added, it decreases the melting point. For example, we'll see if there is a 4 carbon chain, melting point is 7.9 degrees Celsius, and yes, if we see 16.0, okay, means 16S2O means 16 carbon chain, then the melting point is 62.7 degrees Celsius. Yes, there is some trivial names of the fatty acids are derived from the natural sources, like the lauric acid means 12S2O means 12 carbon chain with no double bond. It is isolated from the fats of the lauraceae. Maristic acid, 14S20 means 14 carbon chain with no double bond. It isolated from the seeds of Myristiaceae. Palmitic, from the seeds of Palmiae. Oleic, with the seed in the seeds fat of olive oil. Yes, there is another property of these fatty acids is the isomerism. The double bond in the fatty acid chain, it permit the two type of the geometrical isomers, that is the cis and the trans. Cis isomers have the curved configuration while the trans has the linear configuration. Due to the curve configuration, cis unsaturated fatty acids has the lower melting point as compared to their trans counterpart. Most of the natural unsaturated fatty acid have the cis double bond. Here we can underline this point, that is the mostly unsaturated fatty acid has or it carries the cis double bond. Yes, here in this figure we can see the isomers of each other. In the first figure we can see the saturated means linear structure. Here in the first figure there is a no double bond, but where the trans, okay, in the trans similar to the linear structure there is a one double bond. And yes, what we have seen here, the basically the length of the both hydrocarbon chain are similar, but here the incorporation of the double bond, due to this the melting temperature of this second number of the chain is decreased, means 42.0, okay, 69.6 and 42.0. why? Because there is a double bond in the 42.0 degree Celsius chain. Yes, in the second figure we can see yes, where the melting temperature 10.5 degree Celsius, we can see only one double bond. But where the melting point is or melting temperature is minus 5 degree Celsius, means temperature is decreased when the incorporation of double bond is increases. So here two double bond, so the temperature is decreased. Yes, saturated versus unsaturated fatty acids in the membrane. So mostly in the living cells like the plant, animal and bacteria, they adapt to the decreasing temperature by increasing the proportion of saturated or unsaturated fatty acids in the membrane. Okay, so here in the figure we can see, or we'll take the example of ghee and oil. Okay, in the second number of figure where the viscous is right, we can see it is a compact or saturated hydrocarbon chain. So it we can take it as an example of ghee, and where there is a fluid nature, unsaturated hydrocarbon tails where the kinks are present, we can take it as an example of the oil. Yes, so they decrease the proportion of unsaturated fatty acid in the membrane and increase the saturated fatty acid content in the membrane when the temperature is high. Means at the high temperature the saturated fatty acid is present and the unsaturated fatty acid it is in a less concentration. The fish in the cold environment have the membranes with the high proportion of unsaturated fatty acid to prevent the membrane from the solidifying. Yes, then the fatty acid composition of the three fat foods. Here we'll take the example. On your left hand side there is a one graph is presented where the most fats in our foods are complex mixture of the simple and the mixed TAGs. Yes, here the dark blue color in the graph, the dark blue color C16 to C18 saturated, it codes for the saturated fatty acids. Then see a light blue color C16 to C18 for the unsaturated, and C4 to C14 it is for the saturated. Yes, so in the first we can see olive oil liquid. Okay, the more concentration of unsaturated C16 to C18, okay, very less concentration of C4 to C14, and the minute concentration of C16 to C18 saturated. Yes, in a butter Why in olive oil? Because olive oil is a liquid. So in a liquid state, the unsaturated fatty acids are most. As we take an example of oil and ghee. So yes, next is the butter. Butter, it is a soft solid. Solid means what? The which bond is more or which thing is more over there? It is a saturated. Yes, saturated things is more. So saturated fatty acids are somewhat more. And in the last, we can see beef fat, which is a hard solid. We can see the saturated fatty acid concentration is more. Yes, the transgenic canola oil with the low saturated fatty acids. Here the overexpression of the delta D desaturase in a canola can reduce its contents of saturated fatty acids, which can lower the risk of heart attack. Yes, here omega-3 fatty acid or omega fatty acid, it is also known as the linolenic acid. Yes, there are the or how we can say that it is a omega-3 or omega-6 fatty acid. In the figure we can see at the one point there is a acid end, means carboxylic acid end, to which the hydrocarbon chain is attached, and the last carbon atom is the methyl group. Okay, so here the omega number, how the omega number is given? The omega number indicate the position of the first double bond in a fatty acid counting from the methyl end. So here we'll take the methyl end, okay? From the methyl end carbon, first carbon, then second, then third. In the first figure, we can see the double bond is at the third position. So it is a omega-3 fatty acid. In the second figure, we can see from the methyl end, the double bond is present at the sixth position. So this is the omega-6 fatty acid. Yes, the members of an omega family may have the different length and the different number of the double bonds, but the first double bond occur at the same point in all of them. These structures are drawn linearly here to ease of the counting carbon and locating the double bonds. Now, waxes means what? As I told you, it is the esters of the long chain, saturated or unsaturated fatty acids and alcohols. We'll see the functions of waxes. It acts as a storage fuel for the some microorganism. It protects your skins and hairs. It prevents the excess water evaporations in the plant. It protects against the parasites. And it has many applications in the pharma cosmetic industries. Yes, here are the classification of the lipid on the basis as it is a structural element, means as I told you, it is a storage and the structural. So on the basis of structural, there are the many classes: membrane lipids, phospholipid, glycolipid, archibacterial ether lipid, and the sterols. Phospholipid are further classified to glycerophospholipid, sphingolipid. Glycolipid further classified to sphingolipid and sulfolipid. Yes, this is the structure of glycerol. This is the basic structure of glycerol phosphate, where the L glycerol molecule at the third carbon, there is a phosphate group is attached. This is the backbone of the glycerophospholipid. In the TAG, the backbone is glycerol. And here the backbone is also glycerol, but at the third position the phosphate group is attached. Yes, this is the general structure of the glycerophospholipid. We can see the backbone of the glycerol to this glycerol molecule. At the R1, R2, there are the two different types of the fatty acid chains can be attached. And at the third position, at the third position of the glycerol, there is a phosphate molecule is present. So this is a glycerophospholipid. And to that phosphate, the X group, means head group substituent, it can be changed. This group is attached. The type of fatty acid that connect to the L-glycerol phosphate at the third position. Yes, Then this glycerophospholipid means at this X position the different group can be attached. So which are the different groups? So that different group, it may be simple hydrogen. If it may be a simple hydrogen, then the name of that glycerophospholipid is phosphatidic acid. If at that X group the ethanolamine group means CH2CH2NH3 group is attached, then the name of that glycerophospholipid is phosphatidyl ethanolamine. If at that X position the choline group is attached, then the name of that glycerophospholipid is phosphatidyl choline. Same like a phosphatidyl serine, phosphatidyl glycerol. Yes. Then there is a phospholipase enzyme. This phospholipase enzyme, in its name only, it is used to break the bond. Okay, so there are the four types of the phospholipases enzyme: phospholipase A1, A2, C and D. So the functions of this all is the different or the same, just breaking the particular bonds in these glycerophospholipids. Okay, so we'll see first of all phospholipases A1. Phospholipase A1, it is present in many mammalian tissue. Okay, we can see here where the bond is break. Okay, the middle in a yellow portion, we can see there is a glycerol backbone is, or the glycerophospholipid is shown. CH2O means R1, R2, and at the third position there is a phosphate group to which the X different head substituents are attached. Okay, so A1, where it is break from the R1, okay, at the carbon 1 of the glycerol, where it break in the carboxylic group. Okay, then we'll see the phospholipase A2. A2, it is present in the many mammalian tissue and the pancreatic juices. It also present in the snake and bee venom. It is a very important phospholipase. It acting on the phosphatidyl inositol and release the arachidonic acid, which act as a precursor for the prostaglandin synthesis. Then in the pancreatic secretions are especially rich in the phospholipase A2 proenzyme, which is activated by the trypsin and require the bile salt for the activity. It is inhibited by cortisol or glucocorticoids. Now we can see where the A2 break the bond. It is in the at the second position of the glycerol, it break the bond in the carboxyl group. Yes, in between the carboxyl group. Now we'll see phospholipase C. It is found in the liver lysosome. Okay, then it is a membrane bound phospholipase C is activated by. So this phospholipase C, it is a membrane bound enzyme. This is activated by PIP2 system, and thus it plays the role in producing the secondary messenger. Okay, so where it is break? At the third carbon, we can see glycerol third carbon, where the phosphate group is attached. It break in that phosphate group, from that phosphate group. Okay, and phospholipase D, it break for the X group. Okay, the head substituted group. Yes, if there is abnormal accumulations of the membrane lipids, it can causes the different types of the diseases. Okay, the diseases are named over here in the pink color. Yes, there are the diseases associated with the inability to recycle the sphingolipid. Here there is a pathway to recycle involved converting the sphingolipid to the ceramide. And if there is a lack of function of the one of the enzyme at any point, it leads to the accumulations of the sphingolipid product in the nerve Schwann cells or the deposit in these cells that causes the different types of the diseases, or nerve do not work rightly. And there are the many symptoms like the mental retardation, paralysis, blindness or the early death. Here we can see in a pink color there are the different diseases are mentioned, like the Tay-Sachs disease, generalized gangliosidosis, then the Sandoff disease, Fabry disease, Gaucher disease. Okay, yes. Next, what is mean by the sterol? Sterols are the derivatives of the cyclopentanoperhydrophenanthrene. Yes, they are the structural lipid which are present in the membrane, okay, of the most of the eukaryotic cells. Cholesterol is the major sterols in the animal. We'll see the example cholesterol. It is a derived lipid, okay. Cholesterol is what? It is a structural lipid plus it is a derived lipid. It is widely distributed as a sterol in the animals and the humans, okay. It is mostly, probably it is present in the animals. It is a main component of the cell membrane. Then vitamin D, hormones and the bile acid, these three components are synthesized by using the cholesterol molecule. Bile acids are essential for the normal digestion and absorption of the fat and fat soluble vitamins. These are synthesized in the liver. And increase in the dietary intake of the cholesterol, it increases its synthesis in the body as well as which leads to the coronary heart diseases. Unsaturated fats, it reduces the level of cholesterol in the blood. Yes, there is LDL, HDL and VLDL. LDL means low density lipoprotein. Okay, low LDL, it is a bad cholesterol, and HDL, it is a good cholesterol. Okay, LDL, what is its function? It transports the cholesterol from the liver through the blood to the tissue. Okay, means it is a bad cholesterol, means it transports it from the liver to the tissue. Then HDL. HDL means high density lipoprotein. What is its function? It transfers the cholesterol from the blood to the liver where it is metabolized. Liver, it is an organ where the metabolism of the cholesterol is occurs. So transporting of the lipid from the all body of, or transporting of the cholesterol from the all your body part to the liver is important for its metabolism. So it is a function of the HDL. So it is a good cholesterol. Okay, HDL is good. So if its concentration is more, then the low risk of heart attack. And if LDL is a bad, if the concentration is more, then there is a high risk of heart attack. Yes, next is the bile acid. This is a structure. These are the polar derivatives of the cholesterol that act as a detergent in the intestine. It is your detergent in the intestine, emulsifying the dietary fats to make them more accessible to the digestible lipases. Yes, there is essential fatty acids. There are some essential fatty acids like the linoleic acid and the arachidonic acid. What is the linoleic acid? It is a omega-3 or omega-6 fatty acids. Essential fatty acids synthesize the structural fat in the tissue such as the prostaglandin, leukotrienes, prostacycline, thromboxanes, which regulates the body functions such as the blood clotting and the inflammation. There are some essential fatty acid deficiency can result in the abnormality like the poor growth, increase the food intake, scale inflammation of the skin and impaired immune system. The best dietary source is the vegetable oil, okay, corn oil, sunflower oil and the oil rich fish. Trans fatty acid, which are present or which are not good for your health, it is exist in a very small amount in a natural foods. Trans fatty acids, it lowers the HDL level and rises the total blood cholesterol. So it rises the LDL level and decreases the HDL. HDL is a good. So trans fatty acid is not a good thing. They also raise the plasma concentration of the lipoprotein. It's atherogenic lipoprotein. Then trans fatty acids are formed when the vegetable oils are hydrogenated during the formation of the margarine. These are the some points which are highly related to the phases. As I told you, saturated and unsaturated fatty acids. Saturated means solid or compact stage. We can call it as a gel phase and liquid. For example, oil phase, where the unsaturated fatty acids are more, we can call it as a liquid phase. Yes. The phase behavior of the lipid bilayer is determined by the strength of van der Waal interaction between that lipid molecules. Yes, the extent of this interaction is governed by how long the lipid tail and how well they can be packed together. Yes, at the given temperature, a short tail lipid will be more fluid than an otherwise identical long tail lipid. Yes, here the temperature and the length of the chain, it can be also affected by the degree of unsaturation of the lipid tails. Unsaturated double bond can produce a kink in the chain which disturb that periodic structure. This disruption, it create the free space within the bilayer so that it allows the flexibility to that chain. It is a disruption of packing that leads to lower the transition temperature with increasing double bonds. Yes, as the double bond is increases, the temperature is decreases. This is a particularly powerful effect. We'll take an example of the everyday life, like a butter, which has a large percentage of saturated fat. Butter or ghee, it is a solid form, so saturated fatty acid is more. Yes, and it is in a solid, in a room temperature, while vegetable oil, it is in a liquid at the room temperature, so it contains the unsaturated fatty acids. Thank you, everyone.